So have good fun. Please do make your own diary so that once you go back, you can recapitulate. The whole objective of this is that you learn. Then we have a Podar International and we have Ryan International. So welcome.
So Ms. Pratibha will give you the details what we're going to do. We are going to...
Afghanistan, Cambodia, please raise your black cards to mark your attendance.
Okay, so this is a roundtable conference which is MUN based. So we will try to make sure that this is similar to a MUN as far as we can. So there are certain rules that you will need to follow. First of all, after the opening speeches will be the debate speech, wherein you will submit as a clause, and then we will debate upon the clause.
Good morning to everyone present here. Our team recognizes Afghanistan. The past 3 decades of war and disorder have had a devastating impact on the Afghan people.
Overwhelmed to have got this opportunity to represent the Southeast Asian country of Cambodia with its present-day capital in Phnom Penh. In 1953...
Libya is in the Maghreb region of Northern Africa surrounded by the Mediterranean Sea. On 1st September 1969, a group of military officers,
warning all student delegates from different schools and different countries
As representative of Sri Lanka, we will be presenting our position on Sri Lanka.
At 86 children have died in the current ongoing civil war as being used for military child soldiers, and employment rates of these youth are heavily dipping.
In Rwanda in 1994, there were two groups of ethnic classes, the Hutus and the Tutsis. They involved themselves in mass killings of groups of other people. Therefore, the separation of these groups took place.
We must act forcefully and effectively. The situations described in the Secretary General on Children in Armed Conflict 2008 are very telling. Today, in 36 conflicts around the globe
and have been very turbulent in Sri Lanka, Sri Lanka also notices that the government has attempted to protect the rights of children through initiatives such as children's.
Would like to this prevents any children from dying further in the wars wars going on today around the world. Children are one of the most affected of these wars. Thus, if this
intervention, so is it actually with current efficiency, is it possible to actually evacuate children during such times?
I think so. It is possible for in current times to actually efficiently evacuate all children, because the future of a nation are children. And thus, if the government, I think they will actually put in various resources and methods to efficiently evacuate all children, as they will be the future of the nation and they will be the ones who will be
Cambodians.
The child refugees would evacuated to Cambodia, and these later on went and helped Cambodia in the labor force. Increase in manpower and human resources.
Who are put under such appalling conditions are also susceptible to being recruited and trained as suicide bombers by groups such as Taliban, including the Tehreek-e-Taliban.
Has been done for this? VDC, Center of Documentation of Violations in Syria, LCC, Local Coordination Committee.
Now move on to voting for this clause. All countries that are for this clause, please raise up. Clapping is in order. Police officers in war zones to provide greater safety and respect to women to prevent sexual abuse in such countries.
Quoted is inferior. They're not given equal rights as the men are given. Most armies have a majority of men. If women are put into the army forces
in times of war, by putting them in the military forces or the police forces, we're efficiently training them and in effect preventing them from being sexually abused during war times. We're reducing the chance
to defend themselves and their rights in order of crisis, or to protect them from being sexually harassed or abused, and therefore by putting them in military.
Sri Lanka also agrees with the current clause, because not only will this help women protect themselves, but also, as has been proven by psychology,
all being protected. So most of the innocence of the children had been exploited by the soldiers, and were used as child soldiers for the war.
And those children out there who have been traumatized by either the ongoing war, who have been sexually abused, we also would like to add on that there is a need for making these.
And would like to go against this clause. Because the countries where these kind of wars are going on, their economic value is pretty low. So
the government of Iraq has started the child protection program along with various NGOs, which began operation in
such a clause. And I mean, I'd like to raise some questions about the feasibility. I mean, rehabilitation centers are not easy to set up, and the more conscious effort would require more.
All delegates wishing to vote for this resolution, please raise your black cards high.
The armed forces of a country have the responsibility of protecting that country and its people. So, in the training that
help them to survive and adapt to new types of areas and terrain, this delegate wishes to yield to any
proper civilian techniques, and without techniques to survive properly. This is also in concern for their families, which are back home, who are also worried about them equally. The government, therefore, should think in the best interest of the country as a whole and consider that.
If you declare majority, this clause also passes. Clapping is in order.
You need to compete with other adults who have various skills acquired over years of training to get a job. It won't be feasible that they won't earn a living.
Supports the clause. That yes, counseling centers should be built for children, because children are the future of our country. To protect their future should be
to bring the other backward countries on a stance to compete with the current superpowers such as US, UK, etc. And hopefully it will, as
It's like not for the total time, but after a war, generally the economy of the country is low.
And it is essential that these children are given career counseling. What would happen to the economical stability of the nations in the future if we did not educate?
Not everything, and the skills necessary to work with the competition, the very hard competition in the countries is.
They would also earn a higher income, which would bring about a growth in the economy. And the children are the future, so if they get career counseling,
they can receive help. In remote areas, many of them do not get help and the UN cannot reach. Thus, we should make
of Syria would like to state that the delegates of Syria are under consideration regarding this clause. We do agree that there is a need for building a platform, but this delegate of Sri Lanka proposes the clause, youth parliaments must be set up. A youth parliament of Sri Lanka was conceived and implemented to mark the International Year of Youth.
Further classifies what counts as youth, the certain age group that counts as youth, because generally what is referred to youth are people in the teenage years, and the delegates of Syria believe that. So there's no certainty that's going to be working in each and every country, such as Syria. There's a civil war going on, and you're telling us that you want us to set up a youth parliament to train people.
Goes against the topic, as if the youth parliament is made for youth, it is acceptable, but
it will be participating, and the new generation will have the new ideas than the old people. I believe that the new generation,
we do not say that the youth will not have new different ideas and will be the new future of the nation and the leaders, but we do not want a youth parliament to take the decision of the whole nation. We are telling that we want something else, and it's not clear enough, because what we understand from the clause is that the youth parliament is being set up to take decisions for the whole youth and for other
this who were made involved in the war, and this is not at all fair, because children must be involved in peace agreements, but they should not be involved in
children are not capable of fighting as such. Because, and plus, even in the war, children have to face a lot of trauma in the war.
I feel that one should study and enjoy his life as a child, but not
fighting wouldn't be taking them anywhere, but education would lead them to think better for themselves. Child soldiers also face grave mental trauma, as they're not
important to protect their interest, and their involvement in military puts them more at risk. And as a delegate, we would like to agree.
Children under the age of 18 should not be mobilized in the army, as children should not be exposed to such violent activities, as it would mentally scar them. They all have innocent minds that should not be influenced by such
bosses with simple majority. Clapping is in order.
The children of Syria have grown for very long in an environment which is mostly dominated by violence and by war. We agree that they have been exposed to this too much, so that they think that this is reality. We need to remove these rose-tinted glasses off there.
Delegate of Syria, do you think will make this curriculum?
It should be a government-enriched curriculum, because obviously it's the government's responsibility to ensure that this should happen.
I'd like to speak for this topic, as a peace curriculum should be inculcated with the students, as they would know the values of peace. So in future,
Youth Convention, it's been a very good experience. I hope it's the same for you guys as well. Thank you for being here.